I'm Brian Shaw, health educator with Sacramento Native American Health Center. Welcome to another exciting episode of the Health Education Minute, where we spend 60 seconds talking to a content expert about something that they know about and that they're passionate about. Today we have Yasmin Andreessen. She's a family nurse practitioner here at SNAC, and she's going to talk to us today about pap smears, something she knows a lot about. Thanks for being here today, Yasmin.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So let's talk about this. What is it that we need to know about pap smears?
So a pap smear is a tool that we utilize to screen for cervical cancer. Once you turn 21, the recommendation is if you have a cervix, you should come in and have that procedure done. You get it done every 3 to 5 years. You can talk to your healthcare provider once you turn that age, and you can discuss the frequency of the screening. So a little bit about what the procedure is. You come in, you take a seat in the exam table. It's really quick. It's, you know, uncomfortable, but not painful. So this is a little model of the cervix, what it looks like. So we use a tool to visualize this part of your cervix, and we use this little thing called a cytobrush. It goes in very gently, very quickly. You kind of take a little bit of a sample, get that out, and put it into a solution. We do that one more time with this other brush. The same, it should be just really quick. Some people don't feel it. And then we send that out to a lab to get analyzed. And then once we get the results, we call you and we talk about them, and we determine your follow-up.
All right, fantastic. So Yasmin, you told us that that a pap smear is a cervical cancer screen. So it's a cancer screening to get done once you turn 21, if you have a cervix, and you should discuss with your doctor the screening frequency, whether it's every 3 years, 5 years, or however often. And it's done by using a brush to collect a sample from the cervix, sent to the laboratory, and then your doctor discusses with you what the results are, and any follow-up that's needed.
That's correct.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for being here today on the Health Education Minute. I hope you learned something, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.